this topic is a unique topic because nobody talks about the controversial issues nowadays. And transboundary water dispute is itself a controversial issue. It's related to the relation amongst the countries. And the thing is, this institution organizing the SAARC Conclave on transboundary water dispute and water for peace, this is itself unique in one sense, that they will learn about the river, international river, international water bodies, as well as they also learn the dispute among the Indian states. So though it's a SAARC conclave, it deals with basically the international river and water bodies. We also learn something from this conclave. There is two major principle guided in transboundary water dispute. First of all, the absolute authority of the state in its water in its boundary, and secondly, there are some convention and there are some jurists also laid down some principle like Helsinki and Berlin Convention as well as the UN Convention. The UN Convention and other customers' rules preferred not to use water unilaterally or withdraw water unilaterally. It should be an equitable sharing of water among the state, riparian state specifically, and to resolve any dispute amicably. There are some settled principle, though it's not a binding effect to the riparian state, because UN Convention on international river, these are not binding because there is lack of signatory, 35 signatory you need to be binding. There is no still there is no less than 35 countries signatory to the UN Convention. So it's a very delicate matter. So these students of this university will learn some different topics of law, which cover which cover the international law and the relation between the states. States mean the Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, and as well as China, because most of the rivers coming from the source in Himalayan range. So we share water with China, India, Bhutan, Nepal, and Bangladesh. Bangladesh is the lower riparian state of among these states. If you see Brahmaputra, there is the upper riparian state is China, midstream is India, and the lower riparian state is Bangladesh. And other Ganges or Meghna or Borak, whatever it is, other rivers are upper riparian state, basically Nepal, Bhutan, and India. There are nearly 53 transboundary river entered from India into Bangladesh. So India for us is very important country, as they are the upper stream, upper riparian state to Bangladesh, and we need some water. Water is the most important thing. Is second most important thing for a human life. If you think how any human being can survive. First of all, we need air. Without air, we can survive 2-3 minutes. Without water, we cannot survive 2 days. Without food, you can survive 3-4 days, 5 days. So water is the second most important thing for human being and for other flora and fauna of this marshland or water body. They cannot survive even few seconds. So for diversity or marine animals or plants, they need water. Otherwise, they will suffer tremendously. They will extinct from the world. So, by this conclave, students will learn this aspect and the scenario of the Southeast Asian nation, how they could cooperate. All the treaties are bilateral between India and Nepal, between India, Bhutan, between India and Bangladesh, because India is a middle stream country. So what we need regional cooperation. It may include China as well. Regional cooperation, SAARC, whatever it may be, SAARC countries may cooperate with each other. Then we can resolve these issues one by one. And this conclave also help to public awareness. The students of this institution, they are the future of the nation. One day they will run this country. So if they know about their environment, how it will keep in the natural form of the as it was, otherwise it will create serious problem to the overall nature. So we also learned from this conclave lots of things. We also share our views. I also talk to some of the students. I find it very unique, and they also work on it. They also go through the what does mean the international river and how its effect if we erect dam for electricity generation and other issues like life and livelihood and the environmental effect. So it will help us, all the nation of the SAARC countries, to know each other's problem. One day it might also resolve these issues. If the peoples know what will affect them, like if a dam is raised, the neighboring people will suffer, and the downstream, there's less water in the winter. So less water in the winter means that it will affect agriculture, it will affect fishermen, as well as the marine animals and plants. So this public awareness is also need. It will create a bridge between the or amongst the SAARC countries. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Actually, my all.